on the 8s with meteorologist Christine Ferreira.
Hi everyone, 618. I wanted to address river stages right now. Here are our major rivers along the Susquehanna, and we are going to see rises later on today. These are the forecasted rises. The rivers will crest today or tomorrow before falling. We do not have any rivers, though, at flood stage right now, with the exception of the Yellow Breeches Creek near Camp Hill. That is a creek, not a river, and we're looking at the current stage at 8.1. It will be falling later today to 7.6 feet. So that is on the way down. Streams and creeks will be on the way down, but still running very high in spots this morning. News 8 Storm Team forecast for you, our rain-snow mix ending in eastern counties. We're already starting to see some clearing out to the west. So clearing skies or becoming sunny is the call. Windy conditions, though, with high temperatures in the 50s. Tonight, clear skies, winds subside. It'll be chilly, temperatures dropping to the low to mid-30s. And tomorrow, after a chilly start, mostly sunny conditions will rise us up into the 60s for highs. How about that? Look for increasing high clouds, though, tomorrow afternoon as a dry front comes through. Here we are live in Carlisle right now with clearing skies. You can see that on our beautiful Carlisle Skycam. Currently 41 degrees, so even if you see wet roads this morning, don't be concerned for freezing conditions. We are above freezing, well above freezing, across the Susquehanna Valley. So you're good to go for your morning commute aside from the wind. Right now the wind is sustained in Carlisle at 20 miles per hour as this system departs. Other temperatures, 37 for both Lancaster and Reading. Pottsville, Selins Grove, Lewistown at 36 are coldest spots, while Chambersburg and Gettysburg are in the upper 30s. Here are the current sustained wind speeds coming right out of the north or northwest. Very brisk, 10 to 20 miles per hour, and that will continue, as you can see here on the predictor, through lunchtime today, and then decrease a little bit as we head into the evening. Winds really dying down, though, tonight as high pressure sits overhead. Live on Super Doppler 8, the bigger picture shows this storm system finally pooling away after an incredibly soggy weekend. Some spots got 4 inches of rain, even higher totals possible. But now high pressure is blowing in from the west, and that is going to keep us dry and sunny for the rest of the day. Take a look. The predictor shows us that trend. Mostly sunny skies, still windy until evening, with wind subsiding overnight. Tomorrow we start the day on a sunny note, and then this dry front comes in. It will bring in some increasing high clouds, but that's about it. Watch what happens on Wednesday, though. This is a little interesting. Depending on the location of this next front, which kind of slithers in from the west, that will depend on who sees rain on Wednesday. If it's up to our north, areas along I-80 could get some rain showers. If it's farther south, looks like we'll get some rain showers Wednesday. Now, that front stays focused over us Thursday and Friday, so that means rain chances are still fairly high in the 7-day forecast here. You see a chance of showers on Thursday, another chance of rain on Friday, a few showers on Saturday as well as low pressure moves away. We're looking for maybe an isolated shower on Sunday. Couldn't be able to take that out soon. But temperatures this week, guys, generally in the mid to upper 50s. That's seasonal for this time of the year.
That's good.
50s aren't bad.
No,
yeah.
Especially from yesterday when it was like 37
yeah.
degrees.
Yeah. Oh, 37 and raining.
Yeah.
The worst.
Yeah. It was not nice.
No. Christine, thank you.
Thank you, Christine.